You know, have you heard of this, Destiny? I just got a bit of a windfall.
Ooh.
Might have heard about it.
Yeah, you may have heard of it.
We have,
what's a windfall?
He did a $10,000 crypto scam, using partly his cancer thing as an excuse for why he needed to scam his fans. But
I just wanted to, I wanted to join real quick because you just got caught lying.
Boogie 2488, you are being confronted tonight. I am 99% sure that you are... You are faking.
No, don't move.
You are faking your cancer diagnosis, Boogie.
Okay, let's hear that.
Let's hear that.
Did the doctor ever tell you, or did he ever say the word cancer?
He said polycythemia vera, which is a form of cancer, as he explained it to me. And no, it is not secondary polycythemia, which is Nicholas DiOrio's explanation for this.
So I think it is secondary polycythemia. Can you explain?
Well, why would he call it? Why would he call it polycythemia vera? Why would he tell me that I have hormone markers in my blood that tells me I have polycythemia vera? Why does he order a bone marrow biopsy to confirm it?
Well, if he ordered a bone marrow biopsy to confirm it, it would be weird that you told us that you already had a diagnosis and a confirmation. If it
because
hasn't been
the markers are in my blood. The hormone markers are in my blood.
Correct.
Destiny.
But you said that you'd received a diagnosis, but now you just told me that you got a bone marrow biopsy to confirm.
It's a diagnosis, and now we're confirming.
Sure.
It's called a confirmation. The hormone markers are already in my blood.
Yep. So I think what happened is, Boogie, based on
it
everything,
with biopsy, yeah. Because I'm wanting to do that, because I'm praying to God I don't have cancer.
He doesn't care.
I'm praying to God I'm taking the one in a million chance that they're fucking wrong, and that there's another reason I have the hormone imbalances in my blood.
Yeah, why are you praying to God 2 years after you said that you have cancer that you don't have cancer?
Because two years ago, they told me I have polycythemia vera based on the fact that I had increased red blood cell counts, increased hemoglobin, and the hormone markers in my blood. And it all spelled pretty definitively that I have this. And so he wanted to get a bone marrow biopsy, but it is intrusive and expensive, so they decided to forego it. I would like to still get it done because I am hopeful, I am praying that there's fucking merciful God of the world that would be willing to let this be wrong, even though it most certainly is not.
So why are you talking about expensive cancer treatments that they don't even know if you have cancer? That nothing has been confirmed
because
yet. It's been 2 years.
They're treating it, dip.
They're not.
Because
how are they
treating it for 2 years?
How are they treating it, Boogie?
Blood test, blood thinners, bloodletting, medications.
Bloodletting.
They're trying to get my weight
Correct.
Down.
Yes.
I'm seeing the doctor every 3 months. I'm doing blood tests mm-hmm. every. Month we're doing it we're
yep
so they don't
so
know if
you
have cancer
know?
Or not so like, can I
hold
this?
My hand
well sure I so it? I mean I can explain everything right so
all right.
Boogie has a condition
Go
called
right
polycythemia which means there's an elevation
polycythemia
in his
vera,
no.
polycythemia vera
polycythemia vera I want to hear a guy who actually knows
polycythemia
something
polycythemia vera
yes,
he knows more about my medical
yes.
diagnosis
yes,
than I do right ahead I was in the room my girlfriend was go right
you
ahead, Destiny. Go right
you
ahead.
Yo, be nice,
okay,
Boogie.
Yeah, I will go ahead. Okay, so I think that Boogie was told that he has polycythemia, which means he has an elevation of his red blood cells. Now, there is a cancer known as polycythemia vera, which is caused by a mutation in some part of your body that causes an elevation of three different levels of things that you'll find. One of those is the red blood cell count. However, when Boogie was talking about the polycythemia, he mentioned a couple things that I thought were interesting. The first was that taking an exogenous hormone, TRT, testosterone, that caused a increase in him developing this condition. So taking testosterone will not cause you to develop a cancer. Not for this particular cancer, it won't. It will cause you to develop secondary polycythemia. The second thing that he mentioned was that his doctor ordered a sleep study. That's because one of the things that can cause your body to produce more red blood cells is if you have hypoxemia, which is a low amount of oxygen in your blood for an extended period of time. And the reason why he ordered that sleep study is probably because Boogie either has pulmonary obstructive something, or he has, as he mentioned, oxygen, sleep apnea. And sleep apnea, which is a decrease in oxygen overnight, can lead to a decrease in oxygen in your blood, which can lead to an increase in the production of red blood cells. All of the things that Boogie described, both the things that cause this and the treatments for it, are consistent with secondary polycythemia. None of these are consistent with cancer. And the fact that he's saying that they've now ordered a biopsy two years ago, you said that you had a cancer diagnosis, but now you've just said now they're doing a biopsy to check for cancer.
Confirmation.
Is this House MD? Are we treating a blood cancer without actually confirming it yet? For 2 years, you've been having a cancer treatment without confirming there's actually cancer there?
Because it was in my blood markers, and that's pretty goddamn definitive. You can Google that, Destiny. When you have the hormone in the blood that is produced by this cancer, it's pretty goddamn definitive. It doesn't show up for just sakes of it.
Can I say something real quick?
Yes.
Boogie, you won't keep saying you're the patient. You know what your body has.
Yes.
But when I go to the doctor, they give it like this, which is like papers.
Because I was going
to
say, Boogie can end this whole thing. Exactly, show me a single diagnosis. Document with polycythemia vera on it. You don't have one. I don't think the doctor ever diagnosed you with it. And
can I ask you something, Destiny? Is it possible that when the doctor was seeing him, they were asking you could have polycythemia, if I'm saying it correctly, or polycythemia vera, but you don't have the cancer version. You have this version.
Correct.
I'm asking him. It could be like a loss of translation type situation.
Yeah. So polycythemia just means you have an elevation of red blood cells. That's all it means. Your red blood cell count is high.
Be fat and sleep apnea can create
sleep
that.
Apnea could do it. Yeah. Anything. That could cause it. And the fact that Boogie said we knew that when I was taking TRT, this was a risk of that. That means that risk is to develop secondary polycythemia. That was the risk, and then that is what ended up happening, unfortunately. But it's not cancer. That was induced because of just a low oxygenation of the blood.
So explain to me, Destiny, why there are markers, hormone markers in my blood that have tested positively for polycythemia vera.
If there was, then he wouldn't
just look at one of your medical papers, dude.
Yeah,
I'm never showing any of these motherfuckers my medical papers. yourself. I said that 2 years ago, and I'm standing by it now. Destiny Jackson Clark, Keemstar, you can see it when I die. It's my goddamn right medical record. I've given you every goddamn phone call, every text. It's never made a single goddamn thing better. I'm not going to do it. Go fuck yourselves.
You could easily do this right now by just showing
I would rather you motherfuckers continue to
okay, well, no, well, here's an easy question.
Goddamn thing. Uh-huh. The last goddamn
you're the one,
thing.
You're the one
last
who piece the of
security I have in the world.
So the easy thing here is if there are blood markers that definitively confirm polycythemia vera as a blood cancer, then why are they doing a biopsy?
Because I'm insisting on it.
Drop the microphone.
No, wait. Why would you have to insist on a biopsy if you can confirm with a with blood markers? It's because you can't.
Because I'm hoping that I are wrong.
If you're hoping they're wrong, then why 2 years ago were you talking about fighting cancer? Why would you be talking about like...
Because I have been for 2 years.
Fighting cancer how? With what? With blood thinners?
Oh, this one's for you, Boogie.
Because... oh, God damn it. Because you treat polycythemia vera almost identically to the way that you treat polycythemia. Because you can't attack the cancer directly. All you can do is treat the symptoms. And the symptoms are identical to polycythemia. Because it's the same thing with the exception of one's getting caused by an external source and the other's being caused by cancer. And in this case, it's getting caused by cancer, Destiny.
So I do think there are different treatments available for polycythemia vera, and I think that the outcomes for that are significantly worse than just having it induced by some other thing like sleep apnea or hypoxia. But I mean,
the treatment plan is pretty identical.
So if there are two huge things. So one, you could show it to a private party and they could confirm, somebody like Keemstar. But two, the issue is that if you want to keep your medical issues to yourself, I think everybody is entitled to that right, obviously. But if you're going
to
come out,
I should have never talked about it to begin with.
Well, hold on.
One of the reasons I was going to do a GoFundMe was because they verify, for the record. They verify.
So
that would be the third party that I would.
Yeah. So GoFundMe does not do the best verification, as has been proven multiple times in the past. But the issue is that you say that you shouldn't have talked about it. But the fact is that you did. You did the day that you got the diagnosis. You were like, well, I was considering doing this, but I just got my diagnosis today. So you did it instantly.
I sat on it for a while.
Wait, on your tweet, did you not say that I got my diagnosis today and then talk about it?
They told me in the office that they were worried about it. Then they did the blood tests. Then, yes, I did tweet about it on the day that I got confirmation. But I sat on it for a couple of months before, or for a couple of weeks before talking about it, because it took a while for us to get the blood results.
So you sat on it when you didn't know the answer? That's not called sitting on it. That's just called waiting for an answer. Also, if you were so keen on diagnosing whether you had cancer or not, why would you wait 2 years to get the biopsy?
I've never followed my Twitter before, but I tend to tweet as it happens. This one I started
real time news, motherfucker.
I don't understand why you're waiting. I don't understand why you wait 2 years.
Solid cancer diagnosis.
There is no cancer. Secondary polycythemia. There is no cancer here. There's no proof of it. You can't show anybody proof of it because it's not real. And I don't know. As somebody that, like, his mom had cancer, it's just a little bit gross, I feel like, when people are talking publicly about fighting cancer and stuff.
Who is the person that faked cancer before? The chick? You know who I'm talking
about.
Oh,
yeah. Only had cancer once. Yeah.
Yeah. That that's a vintage meme.
No, that's classic.
A vintage.
Wasn't it Emily from RuneScape or something?
There's so many people that don't know that meme right now.
Yeah. Can I ask Boogie, is it possible that you just jumped the gun on releasing your diagnosis thing?
No.
You don't think you jumped the gun a little bit?
Anything is possible, sure.
I just don't understand why you won't just go grab a piece of paper and just disprove them.
Because like, I don't have all these feelings.
He has nothing with those words on it.
Number two. And like I said a year ago, when these motherfuckers tried to get
together. Hold on.
This is the one last
excuse.
You're in my marriage. You guys are in everything else. You're in every aspect of my life. Let me have one goddamn.
What guy?
You're trying to tell me?
Tomorrow. That's not everybody. Lead. Boogie lies about cancer than to hand it over to you pieces. Go ahead and print it.
Can you get your patient portal up on your phone and like send it to Tommy?
And I'm not going.
He's never doing that. He does not have a cancer diagnosis. There is 0% chance that he has one. Every leading thing for this cancer diagnosis the doctor talked about has to do with secondary polycythemia. The sleep apnea was a contributor to that, and the TRT was a contributor to that.
Except for the hormone markers in my blood.
But if you had hormone markers for it, that's either a definitive diagnosis, in which case you wouldn't be getting a biopsy 2 years later, or it wasn't definitive, and you would have gotten a biopsy 2 years later instead of saying they're treating you for cancer for 2 years. You just said before that you don't have the money for extra medical stuff. If they don't need that test to confirm cancer, why would you spend extra money on a biopsy they don't need?
I don't know if you heard of this, Destiny. I just got a bit of a windfall.
Ooh.
Might have heard about it.
Yeah, you may have heard of it.
We have.
What's the
he did a $10,000 crypto scam using partly his cancer thing as an excuse for why he needed to scam his fans. I want to
join real quick because you just got caught lying about me to call me.
It seems like a lot of effort to go through.
And now you're being confronted. And now you're being confronted on one of the biggest lies on internet history. And you won't prove it?
No.
You won't prove it?
I'd rather you go ahead and print it.
If this is true, and you lied about cancer, this is the biggest scandal on the internet.
It's not, but go ahead and print it anyway. Go ahead and print it anyway. Yeah. I pretty much proved it. None of you motherfuckers. This 2 years ago, and I'm not doing it today. Go right ahead. Print it. Print it the way it is. Go right ahead.
Print it. Run it.
I'm okay.
So I guess just to wrap up, because we don't want to take all you guys' time tonight. Couple things, right? So the story as laid out, if you look up secondary polycythemia versus polycythemia vera, all of the leading things that Boogie talks about leading to his condition are consistent with secondary polycythemia, not the mutation that would cause polycythemia vera. The things that Boogie says that his doctor wants him to check for afterwards, like doing a sleep study, are consistent with secondary polycythemia, not primary polycythemia. The fact that he says that he had the blood markers or something to confirm it 2 years ago, but is now getting a biopsy for secondary confirmation, even though he says he doesn't have the money for medical bills, but I guess now that he does have money, he's going to waste all of it on biopsying things that are already confirmed, or at least confirmed enough that he wanted to talk about it publicly for 2 years ago, and then use it to fundraise the money that he now has so that he can do the biopsy that I don't even think he's doing, by the way. I don't think he's actually doing that biopsy. I think that's a lie as well. If you wanted to disprove it, all he has to do is show a private party this particular medical thing, and it would be.
And I never
that's
will.
Also fraud. Just fraud.
To summarize, Jesse, you're basically saying he's kind of unlucky. He doesn't have cancer.
I mean, for this particular case, yeah. I mean, if he wants, here, I'll do this. If Boogie can confirm that he has polycythemia vera, and he actually has like a doctor confirmation of the blood cancer, I'll throw $5,000 towards his medical treatment. I'll make that personal pledge right now.
$10,000. You're not seeing my medical records for
20,
not for 50. You're not seeing my
medical records. $5,000. I don't get it. You leak your whole medical history, but you won't leak
just for medical. Okay, so then I just want people to remember in the future then, when Boogie says, I have to do XYZ scam to raise money because my medical bills are hurting so much, he can speak publicly about his medical issues to scam his fans to raise money, but he can't take $5,000 to privately confirm a diagnosis that he already publicly said that he has. I was so right. 100% he was faking it, right? None of his story makes sense. I was so right.
I don't.
It was kind of hard not to soldier boy or and just go, and you fat as
why?
Is that where your mind is going right away?
I appreciate that, Destiny.
All right, bye.
Remember to hit that like and subscribe, and don't forget the notification bell so that my videos show up right in your feed.